Let's get the latest on the storm's track from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, give us the latest and describe Typhoon Nika.
Yes, hi, good morning, Karen. We are still awaiting the 8 a.m. bulletin from PAGASA, no? But based on the 5 a.m. bulletin, what we have seen is that Nika has intensified into a typhoon and is now approaching northern Luzon. It may make its landfall just before lunch over northern Aurora or Isabela. This storm is packing very destructive winds around its center and will bring torrential rains in northern Luzon. So these are the threats that the residents in northern Luzon will have to prepare for. We have widespread to serious damage and then flooding and landslides in these areas the entire day. During the day until at least before sundown, Nika will cross northern Luzon. So this is the most critical day of the typhoons traversing this northern part of our country.
Okay, Ariel, did you mention destructive winds and rains?
Yes, I did, yeah.
Okay, and can you compare just the amount and the strength of the winds and rains compared to, let's say, Typhoon Christine?
So for now, we have no data yet as to how much rain it will dump over northern Luzon, but we are seeing up to torrential rain. So this could be more or less comparable to that of Christine, but this is a fast-moving tropical cyclone. Let's say compared to what happened in Bicol or in Batangas, where in the thick clouds of typhoon or severe tropical storm Christine actually hovered in these areas for a prolonged period of time. We're not expecting that to happen in the case of Typhoon Nika. So there will be lots of rains, but the exposure or the length of time to which the areas in northern Luzon will be exposed to this much rain will not be that long.
Oh, so Ariel, nangangalugan ba dadaan lang ito? Because as of today, there were several schools that have suspended classes already in preparation for Typhoon Nika. Pero pag tinignan natin in Metro Manila, hindi naman umuulan pa.
Yes, because of the large wind field, malaki yung ikot ng hangin ng bagyo. So as far as Metro Manila and parts of Bicol region have been placed under wind signals. Again, it's a warning for the winds. So meron tayong pagbugso ng hangin sa Metro Manila, but not so much for rains. We are just expecting overcast skies, perhaps passing rains. Hindi naman mahahaba o matagal ang mga pag-ulan. So, but unfortunately, our LGUs have to follow a DepEd order, which recommends the suspension of classes whenever Metro Manila will be placed under wind signal number one.
Okay. All right. My last question is, you heard DILG Secretary John Vikramulya. He essentially warned LGUs with landslides. Bakit landslides ang specific warning sa pagdating ng Typhoon Nika?
Yes, because Nika will be traversing or crossing northern Luzon. And northern Luzon is very mountainous, especially in the Cordillera region. No? As we have said earlier, grabe yung ibubuhos na ulan. So, sinabi na kanina ni Secretary Remulia na basa pa ang lupa ng Northern Luzon from Typhoon Marce na dumaan lang last week. So that means that the soil will be heavy and be very prone to landslides. So yung Cordillera talaga mismo, especially sa may Benguet area na pinaka-populated dyan sa Cordillera. But also, because of the amount of rain that will be dumped in most of Northern Luzon, this will all go down to the lowland. So yung Chico River, yung pababa ng Cagayan River, Agno River, Abra River, lahat po lang binagsak na ulan sa Cordillera, bababa sa kalupaan, and that will cause the swelling of the big rivers in these areas. So Cagayan, Isabela will really have to watch out for the expected serious flooding in these areas. And may I also add, Karen, no, there is another tropical cyclone coming in. Just before Nika exits the PAR on Tuesday, there will be two simultaneous cyclones in the country. But itong Ophel po, Webes or Biyernes pa tatama. Kaya yung sinabi ni Secretary Remulia kanina, no, hanggang Sabado posibleng may ulan dahil may papalit po na bagyo sa bagyong Nika, and it will also be affecting the same area na maaapektuhan po ng bagyong Nika. So Northern Luzon will still have to be on the watch, to be cautious, kasi nga by Thursday or Friday, dadaan din dyan sa Northern Luzon ang bagyong Ophel. Maganda rin po ng maraming pag-ulan.
All right, on that note, thank you so much, ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. And I do hope if you get the PAGASA 8 a.m. report, who knows, maybe we can discuss it and update the audience before Head Start ends this morning. Thank you, Ariel.
Sure. Thank you, Karen.